Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. My name is Paulina. If you're new here, welcome. Today I'm going to be doing a part two to my Loyola student Q&A. I did one a few months ago and you guys were really excited about it. You guys sent me a ton of questions and you DM'd me, and I realized that I needed to make another part to this Q&A because you guys had a lot of more questions that I didn't answer or was like very clear about. So if in this video you also have any more questions, make sure to leave it down below and I'll make sure to answer it. And like in the other video, if you're just looking for something specific, down below I'll have the different questions that I answered and their timestamps. And if you click on the timestamp, then you will be able to find that exact question instead of trying to scroll through the video and try to find it, you know. But again, thank you for all the love and support, and let's just get right into it. So before starting, I wanted to give a little background because I know some of you may be new or may be curious. My name is Paulina, like I mentioned, and I am a rising junior at Loyola University Chicago. I'm studying advertising and public relations, and I recently picked up a business management minor. I'm in a sorority. I am involved in different clubs and activities at school, and I'm just a student that thought you guys, especially prospective students, might be interested in knowing about Loyola and what it's like to be a Loyola student. So like I mentioned, if you have any other questions, feel free to ask. Also, I will link down below my Instagram, or like the YouTube's Instagram, and you guys can send me questions there too, and also be notified when I post new videos. So with that being said, let's get right into the questions. A lot of the questions you guys asked were regarding finance, and a lot of the financial aid, scholarships, how do I pay for school questions. Although I don't have a lot of the answers, just because when it comes to financial aid, I've been told that it's very case by case, I can give you a couple of resources that might help you figure out what you may need for your case. So I will link it down below, but if you type in LUC scholarships and click undergraduate or whatever it like may apply to you, there is a whole list of different scholarships that the school offers and the descriptions and how you're eligible or not. And this is a really good resource when trying to find something that'll work for you. A lot of people ask me, how do you apply for scholarships? What's the process like? From my understanding, when you apply to Loyola, you're automatically considered for scholarships depending on your grades and SAT stuff. That goes into consideration when they are trying to decide if they will accept you into the school. So what I'm trying to say is that I didn't apply separately for a scholarship, for my merit scholarship, if like to be clear. And instead I got my scholarship package when I got my acceptance letter. So in my case, it was very simple. I didn't have to do a lot, but I know that apart from those merit scholarships, there are other ones that you may be eligible for, and the school will tell you if you are and request more material and stuff like that if you are eligible. But in most cases, it is very case by case, and if you are eligible for merit scholarships, they will let you know and they will offer it to you depending on your case. But it is very case by case. I do not have a lot of the answers, unfortunately, but someone that does have the answers is the financial aid office, and I'm sure if you call them or email them, they will be able to help you figure out your case and what will work for you, trying to figure out your finances. So regarding a lot of the financial questions, that's the best I can do to my ability because of what I understand. It is very case by case. But in my case, like I said, I just applied and I got my scholarship when I got my acceptance letter. Another big, big question that I got is, what's the best dorm to live in and why? This is really hard just because it's very personal and everyone has different likes and what they need and what they like. I'll share my experience and then I'll tell you a little bit about each dorm and what makes them unique. And then I'll talk a little bit about how to apply for housing. If you didn't know, all Loyola students that are freshmen and sophomore, so first and second years, are required to live on campus. That's why this question is so important, right? For me, I lived in Mertz Hall my freshman year, and I absolutely loved it. At first, I was not excited about it. Let me tell you, I was not excited. I really had fallen in love with the other dorms, and I was like, I do not want Mertz. But when it came down to it, I was stuck in Mertz per se. But it's funny because I ended up loving Mertz, and I recommend Mertz for a lot of reasons. Mertz, as some of you may know, is known as the social dorm. That is because the grand majority of freshmen live in Mertz. Mertz is a 19-floor building, and it's filled with only freshmen. It's divided by, the floors are divided by gender, so one floor will be all girls, one floor will be all boys sort of situation. I was on the 14th floor. I had a really great view. It was really nice to wake up and, see the lake and everything. I had part lake, part Rogers Park, so it was really nice and I really enjoyed my time. A little bit about Mertz, like I said, it's very social just because a lot of freshmen do live there. I think there's about, 25 rooms per floor, I'm not exactly sure on that. And you can get either a single, a double, a triple, and a quad, I think. Don't quote me on that. But I was in a double. My room was pretty small, but not too small. It was I would say it's a regular college dorm room. I found my roommate through the Loyola Facebook because I didn't know anyone coming in, and it worked out. And in Mertz, you have the community bathrooms, 4 bathrooms per floor. Some people may think not the best things about community bathrooms, but it was actually really nice because I got to meet a lot of the girls that I lived around that I probably wouldn't have talked to if I hadn't met them while I was brushing my teeth every night or going to the bathroom or taking a shower or whatever. So it was really nice because I did get to meet a lot of the girls that lived around me. So that was really nice. And I never really had to wait in line or anything. There was always a shower available or a bathroom available. And since there's 4, one in each corner, if one was occupied, you can just go to another one and it would be fine. So that's one really cool thing about that. You do get to speak and talk and mingle with a lot of people, which is really nice when you're coming in, especially if you don't know anyone coming in. It's really nice and you get to know a lot of people. Another big perk is that you will probably be in a lot of freshman classes, which means a lot of your classmates will probably live in Mertz. And when it comes to doing group projects, it's really nice that you just have to go down a couple floors instead of across campus to do your project. I really like that. And another thing that I liked was, although we didn't have a dining hall in the building, it was right across, not even across the street. It was just the next building over. So that was really nice when it's really cold and snowy. But yeah, I really liked my experience at Mertz. I'm glad that I was stuck in Mertz and I didn't get another dorm. Although there are really great things about other dorms, and I, funny enough, lived in a freshman dorm my second year, and let me tell you why. So a lot of you may be wondering, why was I in a freshman dorm my second year? So just to give you a quick little rundown of how it works when you apply for housing for your second year is that it's a lottery system. So my roommate and I got really, really bad numbers. So we were one of the last people to pick, and we got stuck, per se, again, in Regis. And Regis is considered a freshman dorm, although it does have transfer students and it does have upperclassmen students. So that's why we were there. And it's funny because I didn't want Regis. I really wanted anywhere but Regis. And not because Regis is not good. I actually wanted Regis my freshman year, but I wanted one of the upperclassmen dorms. But it actually ended up working out really well because I ended up liking Regis. Regis is really nice because you get your own private bathroom, and the room, in my case, was a lot bigger than my freshman dorm room in Mertz, so that was really nice, and the building is a lot newer. It's really, really close to everything, which is one thing that I loved. It's close to Starbucks, it's close to Damon, it's close to all the academic buildings. It was close to the shuttle, which I used a lot. So it was a really great location. Probably the biggest perk of Regis. Kind of going down the line and talking about the other ones and their nice perks. Simpson, which is right across the street from Regis, just recently got a renovation. I haven't been inside since the renovation, but I know that Simpson also is a very social dorm just because some of the floors, I believe, are mixed. So you do get a lot of you do get the opportunity to get to know your suite mates and have a lot more opportunity to run into people and get to know people. You share a bathroom with another room, I believe, so it's like a few girls or a few guys share one bathroom. The other nice thing is that you have a dining hall in the same building, so you never have to leave the building if you get hungry and it's cold. It's really nice. You just literally have to go downstairs and you have a dining hall there. So that's a really, really nice perk of Simpson. Going down the line a little further, going down that same street, the next dorm would be DeNobly. And DeNobly, I've been in all the freshman dorms. DeNobly is really nice. It's also one of the newer ones, and it has, you have a room, which from my understanding is like, the rooms I've been in DeNobly are pretty big for like a double. And the bathrooms are like community style, but they're a little different than the Mertz because you have a like door that separates you from the other bathroom, like toilets and showers, versus in Mertz, it's just kind of like a stall. So it's kind of a like an updated kind of version of a community bathroom, which is really nice. DeNobly also has a dining hall in the same building, which is very convenient if you get hungry and you don't want to go out in the cold, you just go downstairs. But that's a couple. Oh, and another thing that DeNobly has is that it's pretty close to like Mundelein and Cuneo and all the academic buildings where you might have classes. So that's a really great perk about that. Literally right next to DeNobly is San Fran. San Fran is really nice as well. It's very similar to DeNobly. The only difference that you might get is that you might have a suite style, I believe they're called, where you share a bathroom like connected with another room. I've been inside of them. The rooms are like pretty much like the other, like size-wise the same. You can either get those or community style. I think they mix it up in the building. I've only been to San Fran a couple times, so I don't know too much about it, but the really nice thing is, although you don't have a dining hall, they have a little cafe right under San Fran, which is really nice, and you have DeNobly right next door, so you will be fine in terms of food. All of the dorms are very close to dining hall, so that is not a worry. But yeah, it's also a really rather new and nice dorm. They're all like really nice. And last but not least, Campion. I've only been in Campion like twice, but Campion is known to host its honors students, although I believe last year it hosted non-honors. I could be wrong, but I believe that's what I heard. But mostly it's for honors students, and it's very much like Mertz, but in a smaller scale. It has like the community bathrooms, but then you have your dorm like room to yourself. I believe that the like setup of the building is a little bit different. I went in there once and I was a little bit lost, but that was just because I had never been in, Campion. I did it for like move-in volunteering, and but it was really nice, and the rooms are pretty spacious. So all in all, the dorms are really nice, and whichever you pick or end up in, you will find to like, I believe. Some people were asking me how the process works. I applied for it more than 2 years ago, so it's a little fuzzy, but from what I recall, when you accept your enrollment to Loyola and you send in your deposit, you're eligible to apply for housing, and you like rank the different dorms and the ones you'd like. And for me at the time, I was like, sure, I want Regis. My heart was in Regis, and funny enough, I got it my second year, right? And I didn't even put Mertz as an option. Like, I did not want Mertz, and I got Mertz. So my advice to you guys is, do not stress about housing, because wherever you end up, it's gonna be okay. All of them have amazing perks for different reasons, so do not be stressed. Like, I was way too stressed, I remember. And I ended up loving Mertz, even though I didn't want it, I love it now. So don't stress about it. I believe you first get your building assignment. They'll tell you what building you're in late June, or like mid-June. And then you get your floor and your floor and like room number towards the end of July. Like, it's a separate like time, like they don't tell you both at the same time for some reason. Also, another tip or like advice is that Don't stress about roommates. Like, I know a lot of people were freaking out before applications for housing were due. You can change and modify and add or remove roommates as you go through the process. I didn't get my roommate until after I got my building assignment, and I was still able to add her on, and she was able to add me on. So don't stress too much about roommates. It's gonna work out. And like I said, don't worry about where you end up in your like housing assignment. It's gonna work out. All the dorms are wonderful. So that's my tip on that. If you have any other questions, let me know. I'll be happy to answer. Another question that was very common was, what was your GPA, your SAT, your ACT scores? Like, what's the average coming in? I went straight to the Loyola website for this because I wasn't too sure myself. I believe this is from last year, so I'm just gonna read a couple statistics from the website. There were 2,774 freshmen enrolled. From 47 states and 47 foreign countries, so really cool. We have a lot of international students. I myself am an international student. And then it says that the average weighted GPA is a 3.78. ACT composite was 25 to 30. SAT verbal was 570 to 660. SAT math is 550 to 650. And 98% received need-based financial assistance. So that just kind of gives you a little bit of a breakdown of what they have on their website. If you look up GPA SAT LUC, it'll direct you to the page that I'm on. I can also link it down below. But I think it's nice to know those numbers so you can see where you stand. But like I said, with the financial thing, it's the same thing as getting into Loyola. It's very case by case. It's a very holistic process. And it's not like then you have to fit the numbers. It's like very like, it's not just about one thing, it's about who you are as a person. So I just wanted to clarify that. Okay, just a couple more questions that I had. Shuttle versus train and the benefits, and if you need to go to Water Tower campus. So if you are a business, communication, education, social work, I think those are the four. I'm not sure, but for sure business and communication. And there's like law classes down there too. You would find yourself taking classes probably more than one semester at Water Tower campus. I'm advertising and public relations, like I mentioned, and the grand majority of my classes are at Water Tower. So a lot of people were asking what the shuttle was like, if it was worth taking it versus the train. I like the shuttle. I think it's really nice because it takes you exactly where you need to go. It drops you right off where you need to be. And it's mostly comfortable. It's warm during the winter season and it's just really nice. It comes around usually every 15 to 30 minutes depending on the time. And I can go a little more into that, but it's very like, for the most part, you will have no trouble with it. The other option is the train. You do have a Ventra pass that you get as a student. And a lot of students opt to take the train. I think it's just a personal preference. If you do have classes at Water Tower, I suggest you try both and you see which one you like, because it is really up to everybody. But in my opinion, I love the shuttle. Well, it does what it's meant to do. It takes you to the Water Tower campus and back. And it does run, I think, from 7 a.m. to 12 a.m. So it's really nice because even if you have night classes, you will be able to get back home and not have to take the train if you don't like to take the train at night, like me. Another question I had come up a lot was, what are the class sizes like? I've had classes as small as 12 students, and then I think the like biggest class I had was 50 students. And most of my classes are in between, so I want to say about 30 to 40 students per class, sometimes a little less, sometimes a little more. It really depends on what kind of class you're taking. If you're taking a core, it's probably going to be a bigger size class. And if you're taking a more specific major class, it's probably a little smaller. So I think it usually would range around that. I probably wouldn't go a lot lower or a lot higher, but that's just based on my personal experience. One last question I had was, how do you deal with the cold if you're coming from such a warm climate? To be honest, I think it's just a learning process. For me, I just made sure to invest in some good snow boots, rain boots, raincoat, snow coat, like all the different things. Make sure you're able to layer, have like beanies and hats and scarves and gloves. And although it may be a little excessive at first, you're like, do I really need all this stuff? I think if you're just prepared for the cold, you won't have so much trouble with it. And I feel like you start getting used to it as time goes on. I feel like this winter was a lot easier for me to deal with than my first winter. And it's kind of funny, now that I come back home, I'm having like trouble adapting to the warm weather. So it's definitely interesting how your body adapts. But as long as you have a good coat and some nice snow boots so you don't slip and fall, and just, you know, take your precautions, you will get used to the colder weather. But it's just like a process that you need to go through. And yeah, but yeah, I think that's the end of the questions that I got. I try to mix a couple of the questions to make this video roll a little bit smoother. But if you guys have any other questions, I know a lot of you guys have questions about Greek life. If you have any specific questions, make sure to leave it down below. I'll make sure to answer it. Or any questions about Loyola in general, I'm always happy to make a part three. And like I said, just like this video if you enjoyed the content. It'll show me that you guys did like the content. If you guys want to see anything else in particular, I'll be happy to make it. I promise I won't take as long as I did before to make new videos. But thanks again for all the support, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!